There you are. So what we'll look at today is how you can add annotations to a live web page and then use that as a screenshot to use somewhere else, or you might even be able to use it if you're looking at a web page as part of a Google Meet or as part of a lesson where you want to highlight something that's on the page. Thanks, Casey, for this tip. Now let's go and take a look. All right, so first of all, you'll need to find the Chrome extension. Now, there are a few different similar tools out there. This is the one that we're recommending at the time being. So it's called Page Marker Draw on the Web. The link's down in the crotch box. What you need to do is, once you found that, hit the Add to Chrome button, add the extension. You load it on this page. You can ignore that, close that. And what you're able to do is, using the splodge mark here, you can click on that, find that extension, there it is there, and then you can hit the pin to pin it to your toolbar, so you've always got nice, easy access to it. When you're on the page that you want to start annotating, simply go ahead and click on the extension there, and you've got your usual drawing tools there, so you've got straight lines, highlighters, you can erase stuff. What I do like about this particular extension, so say you highlight something and then realize that you want to adjust it, you can actually click on the select tool here and then select what you've done and change it to what you need. You can change the colors of your pen as well. So now the next one I'll do, so there we go, we can change the colors. You can use the eyedropper tool to choose a color on the screen, for example, and go ahead and, you know, have some matching colors and so forth. Add text, add straight lines. If you're done, you can go ahead and clear everything off. I'll add a few more annotations back in just to show you what's going on. Now, if you want to use a screen grab of this, you can use the screen capture tools already built in and take your screenshot that way. It does also give you the option with this this one here to download the screenshot. What's nice about it is that you'll only get what's actually on the page. So if we open that one up, there you go. So it only showed you what's actually on the page. It doesn't give you all the toolbars and so forth. And there's your annotation. So for example, if you're sending home instructions to parents about what to click on a page, or you're doing some instructions for students, this is one way of doing that. When you're done with your annotations, you can use this exit button down here, or you can simply click on the extension again in your toolbar, and that will make it go away as well. All right, so I'm pretty sure you'll be able to think of some different ways of using that particular tool. As always, if you have any dramas, you know where to find me. Have a good one.